legal, but recently they changed, the EPA's changed their mind again and now it's okay. Because this is just putting out condensate. Condensate is just, like when you're driving or when your car's, when it's really cold outside, you get in your car, your window is all fogged up. Once that fog melts or turns into water, that's condensate, basically. So there's nothing poisonous about it. That's why the EPA's changed their mind again. And we can run it through stormwater. So want to make it as easy as possible to run this pipe out to a gutter. I'm not going to run to this side because then I'll have to come out, drop down, run under the unit, and by the time I have the right gradient on my drain pipe, I might already be, through the toilet window. So hopefully, if we run this way to this gutter, we should have enough distance to fall down to the gutter with the pipework. Now let's give that a go. I'll go to the section view. Let's click on this graph symbol. And because we're draining, we want a slope on the pipework. We want a gradient. Now I can't just draw the pipe on a gradient like that and leave it. Or I can start drawing the pipe and go up here to your slope piping toolbar or slope down. Water slope down. And this value, see what that is. That it makes 1 to 80. Even though I'm trying to draw a straight pipe, it's not letting me.
Mm-hmm.
It's applying that gradient to the pipe.
Right.
So that'll, I'll change that to 140. Steeper gradient.
Mm, still don't give you.
So looks like 140 will work for my model. Yours should be.
So go across, how far do you go on top of the gutter?
So would you think across to roughly in line with this wall?
Oh, right.
Okay. It's telling me that I can't find a fitting or a beam to connect the unit to the pipework. So, yeah, you can't find a radius bend at whatever that angle is going to end up being.
Mm-hmm.
So let's see if we can fudge it. So we'll go with that. I'll do that again.
Do the plan now.
Yeah, so go back to your plan view. Select your unit. drain point.
Slope off.
So we don't want any slopes.
So slope
off.
Yep.
Come straight out.
So we draw a line first.
Yeah, let's draw flat.
Right. That's good, that's fine. Just come out. That's right, that's off. Come down. Just keep cutting down, down a bit.
Come across?
Yeah, come down, go across. Yeah.
Hang out about
to the door. Up to the door.
It's
going to
drain.
Oh, no.
I think you've got to get your slope in here somewhere.
Yeah, now, hang on. Get back to there, now you slope, do you? Mine says none of the created, they're not visible.
Straight out. You come straight out, just step across to your right. Click, and you're still flat. The pipe is still flat there.
Okay, just drop to about there.
The pipe's green.
Close it.
If you click on the pipe,
stuffed it up. Again.
Sanitary is like sewage or stormwater.
I can't see my pipe in the ground floor because of the height down there.
Oh, yeah, sorry. If you can't see if you can't see the green pipe you're drawing, just go into VV. Under filters, this category is sanitary. So if you select sanitary, if you turn that on, you'll see your green pipe. But just turn all of those on.
Turn all of them on? Okay.
Sorry? Yeah, under filters.
Domestic vent. Okay. Got you now. Oh, there it is. Oh, okay. It's working.
So it's like VV and a second to last part. Sorry. So these are set up for any plumbing drawings. So if you've got your hot and cold water, your drainage, all on one drawing, it's going to be very messy. This is why these filters are set up. So we can break down our drawing into the different elements. We can show our hot and cold water on one drawing, and our sanitary or sewage on a different drawing, and vents. Normally vents, in our company, we show vents on our sanitary drawing because we vent the vents on the sanitary system.
You still need to draw everything on one plan, one drawing. Because you need to see where the plan is.
You can break your views up like you do here. You can turn your open blind.
No. So, modify that.
And then from that endpoint, we'll come across and draw a pipe again. And this time we'll slope down. So turn the slope down front and make sure this is set to 1-40 or just any one of those.
Yep.
Should be fine. I'm going to do that. And draw this pipe just to the end of the house, to this wall.
Just past it, or it doesn't matter?
We can go into section and fine tune it.
Yeah.
As long as you're
inside the wall.
Close to here, that's fine.
Mm-hmm.
Just to make this a bit neater, we'll drag this up a bit. In real life, you'll offset these pipes equal distances on your plan drawings. By real life, I mean documentation-wise. on the site or in the ceiling, they'll just do what,
it works.
What fits. They won't actually offset each pipe by 150 mil. But this is just to make sure it's documented clearly and you can see what you want. We all there? All got our drain pipe running to the end or outside wall. So once we're there, just go to that section view. Make sure your section view is looking at that visor. Go to that view. And we're running outside of the roof. I am anyway.
2:45.
What?
2:45 right there.
And that's what we'll do next. So now we'll spring this pipe in. And we'll try and run from that point just to this point. So we'll draw a pipe again. It's going to slow off for now. And also ignore slope to connect. That should make it a bit easier. Hopefully we don't get any errors. We probably could have done that before. Just makes up the things. That angle is 21.784 degrees. So if you want to go to Bunnings and buy one of those, we'll go ahead and try. But for documentation, for design purposes, we'll just.
Wait, we are
not
the
That's why the guys on site get frustrated with designing. We do stuff like this.
So what kind of pipe would it be? Would it be a ceramic pipe or a flexi-core pipe? Because I've seen hose pipe. So they put that in the gutter, that's it.
It's using plastic.
Just draw this pipe out to here. Draw pipe again. Make sure this is selected.
What did they just say? The slope command.
Once you click on this point, or click on a pipe, and start a new pipe, then this should show up. If it
does,
then you modify it better.
What happens if your pipe doesn't show up in the section view, but it's in your plan and your 3D view?
It needs a natural arrow on the section, but on your floor plan view.
So I can see everything in there other than the pipe.
You can use your section view depth.
So is your pipe showing up in plan?
Yeah.
I was mistaken.
Just
come from the valve and the screw. 5 hour measure.
In real life, when you do that, they just drill a hole straight through the face, you just get the plastic like concrete to it. Poke it out, glue it if you're lucky. Yeah, so just trip it out and do what you want to do anyway.
Oh, it's recording. Let's stop it.